Welcome back, students. Now we will discuss about de Broglie wavelength of matter waves. Now in the previous lecture we discussed about that what is a matter wave. So again I'll repeat it here that what is a matter wave. Matter wave is if any material particle is having some velocity with mass, that is momentum, then wavelength associated with such kind of moving particles is known as matter waves. In simply you can say waves or wave associated with moving particles is known as matter waves. So wave is there, then wavelength would be there. So we need to find out that what is the wavelength of these matter waves. So since we have this energy for a moving particle, for any kind of a particle, we have energy from Einstein's equation, that E is equal to mc square. Let us keep it equation 1. For any wave, E is equal to h into f, or E is equal to hc by lambda, equation 2. Then from 1 and 2, as both are energies, so we can equate them, that is m into c square is equal to hc by lambda, the c and c cancelled. So from here m is equal to h upon c lambda. So therefore momentum, that is p, is equal to mass into speed. So here this momentum m is equal to h upon c lambda. If the speed is c, then this cancelled out. So from here momentum is equal to h upon lambda. So we can say that lambda is equal to h upon p. So for mass m, for this mass you can see here this momentum p becomes m into v. So for a particle moving with v and having mass m, p is equal to m into v. So therefore lambda is equal to h upon mv. So this is the wavelength which is associated with a particle of mass m moving with a velocity v. Now such waves are known as matter waves, what we discussed. And one condition is there that these waves are not electromagnetic in nature. Okay, these are not electromagnetic in nature, they are just waves. Here we are discussing that a particle will possess both the natures, particle nature as well as wave nature. So see, the wavelength which we calculated is representing a wave nature, and this momentum is representing a particle nature. And de Broglie, he combined these two natures and gave a formula. Earlier what was there, these two natures were separately studied, they were not combined. It was assumed that if a particle or if a physical, if any quantity is having a particle nature, then it will not exhibit a wave nature, and if something is exhibiting a wave nature, then it will not exhibit a particle nature. But de Broglie, he connected these two and he told that anything can exhibit both these natures. It will exhibit a particle nature as well as a wave nature. So he connected these two, and by, while connecting it up, he got this derivation. He got this formula for wavelength of the matter waves. Earlier it was just theories that it can show or not show, but he gave a formula to calculate a wave nature for a particle nature, or for a particle nature for a wave nature. Okay, I hope it is clear. Any kind of doubts, please feel free to ask. Thank you.